Hello everyone, my name is Serafi and I'm thrilled to have all of you with me. Today we're going to be playing Dragon Stars. Dragon Stars is a very new, very fun fusion deck that introduces the High Dragon type to Duel Links. We're playing Luke, of course, and we're playing the skill Dragia Star Nova, so let's get into it. Dragia Star Nova can be activated if all the monsters in your constructed deck are dragons and all the monsters in your extra deck are High Dragons. You have a multi-choice effect. You can either make the attack of one face-up level 7 light attribute monster on your field with 2600 or less attack become 2700. Or if the total attack of all face-up level 5 or higher monsters on your opponent's field is 1400, 2800, or 4200, add 1, the dragon, 2, 1, 2, or 3, the dragon and or fusion from your deck or graveyard to your hand. You can only add the dragon once per duel. Okay. It's an interesting idea. So if your opponent has exactly 4200 attack points, you could add 2 fusions and 1 dragon, or you could just draw the dragon and fusion if it's 28, which is usually what happens. And then lastly, if your opponent has like 2100 attack points or something, you can get one or the other. This skill is pretty good. Let's go ahead and take a look at the deck. We are playing Multi-Strike Dragon Dragius. This is a level 7 light dragon monster. Send the top card of your deck to the graveyard. This turn, this card can attack a second time if it destroyed a monster. Good. A solid card. Limit 3 for a reason. The problem really with Multi-Strike Dragon Dragius is that it's not searchable. Gravity plus Dragon, level 6, 1600 attack, 1000 defense. Send one card from your hand to the graveyard, choose one face-up monster on the field, and it gains attack equal to the number of face-up Dragon-type normal monsters on your field, times 400 until the end of the turn. Gravity plus Dragon is a difficult card to use. I actually might cut this, to be honest. It's not as good in most instances as the as Fire Dragon, which is just a level 6 2100 with no cost. I had higher hopes for this card when I started playing this deck, and it did not work out. Righteous Dragon, level 5, 1200 attack, 1200 defense. Requirements to shuffle 2 dragons from your graveyard into the deck, and then this turn, this face-up card can be treated as 2 tributes for the tribute summon of a dragon-type monster in attack position. This card's great. This allows you to basically summon multiple level 7s on your board if you need to. For the normal monsters, we are playing Blue Eyes White Dragon, 3000 attack, 2500 defense. 3 copies of Dragonrite, 1500 attack, 0 defense, Earth. 2 copies of App Lizard, 1500 attack, 0 defense, Light. 3 copies of Sir Painter, 1400 attack, 500 defense, light. 2 copies of Dragasite, 0 attack, 1500 defense, light. And 3 copies of The Dragon, 0 attack, 0 defense, light. For spells and traps, we are playing Dragon's Inferno. Pop a spell or trap if you control a dragon. 2 copies of Talismanic Seal Array, which is the only way that we can deal with high attack monsters like the Cyborg Monsters and the Cyber Twin Dragon and Cyber End Dragon. 1 copy of Fusion, because we can search it. 1 copy of Negate Attack, and 1 copy of Buffered Slime. Negate Attack, of course, when your opponent's monster declares an attack, negate the attack, and your opponent cannot attack this turn. And Buffered Slime, when your opponent's level 8 monster declares attack, send the top card of your deck to the graveyard. You take no battle damage this turn, then if your life points are 3,000 or higher, you take 2,000 damage. Now, the main problem with Buffered Slime these days is that there are a lot of level 9 monsters and level 10 monsters on the ladder. For our extra deck, we are playing Hyper Strike Dragon Dragia Star F. This is a high dragon monster with 3,000 attack and 2,000 defense points, level 9. Requirement, if the only monsters in your graveyard are high dragon or dragon type monsters, send the top card of your deck to the graveyard. Either this card can make 2 attacks on monsters and gains 900 attack points, or this turn this card can make up to 2 attacks, including direct attacks, and it inflicts piercing. Very interesting idea. They took the best parts of Dragius and kind of split them apart. You can either attack twice, but you'll be super powerful when you do that, or you can attack twice and potentially directly, but you get no attack points. In most cases, you'll probably end up using the first effect. It's very rare for people to use the defense position in this game, but if they do, then you can definitely just crush them with Dragius. Okay. Is the deck good? No, this deck is not good. I actually almost deranked from Gold 5 trying to record this video and these wins. But that said, if you want to play dragons, this is probably the only way that you can really play dragons right now. Seeing as there's just, you know, that you can't just... There's too much attack points at this point. You can't just play like an Earth Dragon deck at this point. You need a bigger monster. The main drawback of Dragia Star Nova is that it's really hard to actually summon Hyperstrike Dragon Dragia Star F because you need two tributes, and then you need the dragon and fusion, and Dragius. So that's five cards. And yes, you can potentially draw one of those cards with your skill, but it only allows you to consider level 5 or higher monsters. If your opponent doesn't have any level 5 or higher monsters, like if they set everything, or if they're fighting you with level 4s, then you really actually can't use the skill at all, and it's really annoying. Righteous Dragon does help a little bit, but the problem with Righteous Dragon is that sometimes it just becomes a brick in your hand, especially if you draw it on turn 1. Then you have to play Dragon's Inferno, and you have to play Negate Attack and Buffered Slime to try and keep yourself alive, but those cards being in your hand means that you have fewer options for actually tribute summoning, putting dragons in the graveyard, getting pressure on the board. This deck really, more than any deck that I've ever played, feels, well, except for Heroes, feels the restrictions of a 5-card hand, which is weird. You shouldn't have to feel restrictions of a 5-card hand in Rush, but there's so many things you want to do with the spells and traps and your tribute summoning and your other cards that it's kind of frustrating. All right, let's take a look at the replay. All right, so we're going second. Our opponent is playing Galaxy. They summon Bright Sentinel and then set 4. It's our turn. We have Dragorite, the Dragon, Buffered Slime, Talismanic Seal Ray, and Multi-Strike Dragon Dragius. So we're just going to summon Dragius. Use the skill to make its attack points get 200 more, just for damage. Mill 1. Attack twice and pass. We milled a dragon monster. That's good for our Talismanic Ray. The opponent sets 2 more. Our turn. We're going to Dragon's Inferno and pop 1 card. Then we activate our skill. Raise the attack points. Mill again. We normal summon App Lizard. We set our negate attack. And we keep the Dragius and the fusion in our hand. We beat down his 2 monsters and attack him directly for another 2,700. It's our opponent's turn, and they're going to activate their skill, Galactica Order. Galactica Order, send 1 level 7 Galaxy-type normal monster from your hand to the graveyard, then add 1 Secret Order or 1 Meteor Charge from your deck to your hand. Meteor Charge only once per duel. The opponent draws Secret Order by pitching the Galactica Oblivion, activate Secret Order and revive Galactica Oblivion, then activate the Universal Storm face down. And the opponent has 3 potential options, and they are going to hit Negate Attack because, of course, they are. Then normal summon the Trans Am Linac, which I guess he has the silver border for that. Okay, I don't know if that's like normal for that card. Then he activates Meteor Charge to give the Trans Am Linac piercing, and then also switch my App Lizard into defense. Battle. He's going to set 3, then he destroys my App Lizard, I take 1,600, destroys my Multi-Strike Dragon Dragius, I take 700 more, and it's my turn. Okay, this is not good. Our opponent has more back row, they have a pretty solid board, no effects, but we definitely can't beat over this with Dragius. We draw, we drew the Dragon, Righteous Dragon, and Dragon's Inferno. This is exactly what we needed. What a top deck. So we'll summon the dragon, we activate Dragon's Inferno, we pop the middle card, which is Card Restoration. Good. Now we are going to tribute the dragon to summon Righteous Dragon. Then we can activate Righteous Dragon's effect. We shuffle 2 monsters from our graveyard into the deck, and now we can treat Righteous Dragon as 2 tributes. Then we will draw the dragon with the skill. We tribute Righteous Dragon to summon Dragius, then we summon the dragon and we activate Fusion. Now we can fuse our 2 monsters together into level 9 Hyperstrike Dragon Dragius Star F. We activate Hyperstrike Dragon Dragius Star F's effect. We mill 1. Hyperstrike Dragon Dragius Star F gains 900 attack points and can attack 2 monsters this turn. Then we activate our Talismanic Seal Array. We shuffle back. We reduce Galactica Oblivion's attack points. And we attack 4 games. There you go. This is the power of the Hyperstrike Dragon Dragius Star F deck. You can get easy tributes, you can get easy summons and pop spells and traps, and win the game with 1 ferocious finish. My name is Serafi, and I was thrilled to have all of you with me.